Hello everybody, welcome back to another episode of Kenny's Corner. Today I have two redfish that I want to prepare. Now the scale on this redfish is just totally different, something that I've never come across. I mean, I don't work with fish regular because one, I don't like fish, I don't like to smell it, I don't like to taste it, I just don't like fish. But I want to do this recipe for YouTube, for you my viewers, and for anyone else who would just accidentally come across this recipe. I do hope you enjoy watching. I am going to roast this fish inside. I just want to make it as simple and as easy so anybody could follow along. You don't have to have no fancy grill, no fancy nothing. Work with what you have and get the job done. So I'm going to go outside and I'm going to get some fig leaves so we could wrap it in the fig leaf, and then we are going to use I'll put a video of it here because I don't know what to really call it, but it's a rack. It is a rack, so we're going to put it in a rack and we're going to put it on the stove top. Not no fancy grill, not no fancy nothing. We're just going to put it on the stove top. Once you seal it properly in the fig leaf, you wouldn't have any leakage, you wouldn't have any issues with your stove being dirty. Alright, so come along, let's go outside and check out our yard. In the meantime, I want to show you my coconut that I have on my tree ready to pick. That water and those coconut are probably really, really sweet because those coconut are really full. So I'm sure the jelly would be too hard to eat. I like soft jelly, but the water I'm sure is going to be very sweet. So hopefully I can get them picked and enjoy a few coconut water this weekend. And I do hope you checked out my previous video, which was my chickpeas video. So, and also I am going to make a paratha. So look out for that video next. But today I want to remind you, though, if you haven't checked out my previous video, which was the chickpeas and how I fried it and how it came out, please do so. The link would be in the cards above. Now let me stop rambling and get outside in the garden. And I want to ask Pamela, this question is for you. What causes your hair to have two different type of curl pattern? Like in my case, I have noticed, look at this, the roots here, you will have a tighter curl, but when coming on to the end, it's just like this. So what causes this? And is there any way that I could fix this? How could I fix this? Or I can't fix this, or just make a big chop? I don't know if it's a chop I need, or so leave your expert advice. Anyway, let's continue with the rest of today's video. Let's go outside. So let's go outside to get our leaves, and as I'm there, I just want to show you my coconut. They are growing so well. They grow so fast, it's not even believable. Like, it's just recently someone came and picked them, and now I have so much of coconut. But before I continue bragging about how awesome my coconut is, you see how my planting growing? Yeah. So the coconut really growing really well. So again, I guess I need someone to come through and pick them long again and drink some good fresh coconut water. See the beauty about living in the country, hashtag living in the Caribbean. You can grow all these things in your backyard and you don't have no fee to pay, nothing. You understand? You have to ask the government, please can I have a tree in my yard? Let's continue. I have my peas. Finally, ladies and gentlemen, I'm seeing flowers. Finally. Also, my pumpkin flowers in. Guys, It's flowers. Now this need to be removed from there. This was placed in there just to catch and I just left it there. The time is devouring this tub. And the tree, the peach tree is growing so wide and it is kind of blocking some of the time, but it still didn't stop any time from devouring that tub. You can see my peas is starting to flowers. I am so excited because recently I watched the peas and I had a serious conversation and I tell it it's time to be it. So alright, came outside for the leaf to wrap our fish. So I'm gonna pick some young leaves. I didn't want to use too much of the mature leaves, right? So let me show you my planting. You all have seen them when there were some tiny tots. Look how big they are growing. And just now we're gonna have some planting. Don't worry, you all need some planting. So now I had to take off the music in this because I was playing music so loud in this, forgetting about the issue with copyright. And so that there is from the channel that you previously saw, that mixture. So I'm going to use that into this recipe today, and I'm going to use my syringe. So I'm going to use some water, about half cup of water, and I use about half cup also of the mixture that I made, all with Caribbean flavor seasoning. And I'm going to mix that well so it even portions, even amount of water along with the seasoning. Again, the salt in this you can adjust to suit you. All of the measurement for that ingredients is in my previous video, which is the chana, the chickpeas, fried chickpeas. I will leave that link up in the cards and the description. So once I add the water to that mixture, and again, all of the seasonings are from Caribbean Flavors. Also, their website, I will leave it in the description also, so you can check out the variety of products that they carry. So I'm going to put some into the syringe because I'm going to use this to season my fish. Before I continue seasoning the fish, before I season the fish, I washed it with lime and I had it soaking in a nice lime brine. No salt, just lime really. A lime water. So this would be the main source of seasoning in this. So let's get into this fish. Now this red fish, I have never come across fish with this kind of scale. It is something else. The level of scale on this thing was like I've never seen before. The size of scale on this thing, I just cleaned one and I just put away the next one because I just couldn't make it. It was just too much and too hard to scale. The scale was just ridiculously thick. So I'm going to defrost it because after cleaning, I was so tired from cleaning that one fish, that one red fish, I decided to put the two of them back into the freezer. It was so much of work. So let's continue. Alright, so this is the one that I couldn't finish because I was just exhausted from that previous fish. You see how good this one clean, right? The other one, I terribly butchered that fish. When I tell you I butchered that fish, it's something else. But I needed to show you all how thick the scale is on this. Look at this. This thing not moving for nothing under the sun. You understand? And I'm like, but what kind of fish is... what kind of scale is this? This is just different. Look, just look. Look at the thickness, the amount of layers of scale this one fish have on it. It was really ridiculous. I was like, Kenda, no, no matter what knife you use, there is nothing is going to help you to move this process a little faster. You just have to have patience. And that is why I said previously, I had to just stop. But before I continue, I just needed to show you all I wasn't exaggerating and how thick this scale was on this fish. That is why I had to abort that cleaning of the boat fish.
I have never seen scale on a fish this thick. Because I guess I don't like fish, I don't cook fish regular. But the scale on this is so thick, ladies and gentlemen. It's really, really difficult to clean this fish. So to prepare this fish, I'm just going to use the one that I did before because it's a lot of work to clean this fish because the scales Look at that. Just one. This. It's just the size of one. And it's like two or three layers of this because it's really thick. So to push this video along, we will go with the other one. And just to show you how ridiculously thick it is, after cleaning this one, I butchered this fish so badly. Look what I did. Oh, I messed it up real bad. But you know what? Things happen. Alright? So it's cleaned. You can see. But in the process of trying to scale this fish, I butchered up this fish. But we're gonna use it. You know? After all our work. But when I'm gonna do this one, I'm gonna really take my time and do this. So we're gonna do this another time. But this butchered one, let's prepare this butchered one. Now we're going to inject it with the sauce that I just put into this syringe, okay? So let's start this. So now I am going to inject this fish. I am leaving no part of this fish untouched with this seasoning that we have in this syringe. Now this is really, really flavorful and have enough salt. Well, for my likeness, as I said in the previous channel, chickpeas fry recipe, you can adjust the salt. And also I soaked this in a lime water with no salt, just lime, just you know, pat down on the freshness and to clean the fish a little bit, because to work with fish and me is like, oh, real hard, because I really, it's not something that I like to work with at all, because I don't like to smell it, I don't like to eat it, I don't like to taste it. But for my viewers, for YouTube, I will do what I have to do. So after injecting every corner and crevice of this fish, I'm going to use my rack and we're going to wrap the fish into the fig leaf. As you saw me taking the fig leaf and passing it over the heat, that is to make the leaf more pliable, so it would be easy to work with, right? If you go to use it just up the tree, it will mash up. So now I'm going to make sure that it is sealed in front and back and side properly with the leaf, and it has a little lid there to lock it. So I'm going to slide it over it and I'm going to place it on my stovetop. Now you can place this on a grill, or like how I did the bread the other day, you can do it that way. But ladies and gentlemen, I just wanted to make this easy and simple, you know. So I'm going to do this on the stove. There is nothing going to leak anywhere because I make sure and I seal it properly with the fig leaf. And I left it on each side for 20 minutes because we want to make sure we get a nice smokiness out of from the leaf into the fish. And we want to make sure all that seasoning that we added with the syringe is properly well cooked into that fish, and it is infusing that fish and giving it a real, real nice taste. So as I said, I left it on each side for 20 minutes on medium high heat. Alright, and then I'm going to remove it off the fire, and we're going to remove the fig leaf, and that's how easily I made this roast fish. Alright, now you could cook it for about 15 minutes on each side, but I like everything well done, quite honest, especially fish and something like that. But before we continue, let's take a nice little drink. Wink, wink. Let's drink some water, right? Some good coconut water, coconut infused water, to continue with this recipe. So, right, once we just take a nice shot of coconut infused water, we're gonna continue. Alright, so let's open this up and remove the leaf. Now remember, this also will help with cleanup, because with this you have nothing messy to work with, like the rack for instance. There is absolutely nothing dripping off on the rack. There is nothing, no fish even sticking up on the rack, so you easy cleanup. And as I said, I'm going to remove all of the fig leaf, and then I'm going to try and taste a little piece for you all. Please don't judge, I do not like fish.
All right, so yes, the smallest piece I could possibly take, but like that. I know it's ridiculous, but and really tastes good, you know, plenty seasoned, but oh gosh, I just don't like fish. But I was not shocked because I know my capability when it comes into, you know, seasoning stuff and making things taste really good. I know I am good at that, so I wasn't worried about that. The fact that it wasn't too bad, and it's fish I'm talking about, so I mean, that is where I was coming from. And this is the end result of the fish. After removing all of the fig leaf, I added some of the plain seasoning on it, and then I added some mayo and some ketchup and some pepper flakes. So I also made a dip with some mayo and some of the seasoning, that same seasoning that we used for the chickpeas, the fried chickpeas. So I put some of that and that same seasoning with the water. Okay, so the same method that I used to put into the syringe, right? So I used that and I used some ketchup and mayo in it, mix it around, and I used that as a dip for the ketchup along with how I season it. So thank you all for watching, and I do hope you all come again and appreciate your constant support always. Have a good day.